In this video, I'll tell you how much these projects usually cost and point out three things that hopefully your house doesn't have, because if it does, it will definitely increase the price of the project. Today, I'll be talking about level 2 EV chargers, and the costs that I'm going to be mentioning don't include any of the potential rebates that you could receive from the government to help pay for a portion of the project. Wherever you live, there's a good chance that the government has some sort of incentives to help you out. Where I live in British Columbia, people are often eligible for BC Hydro to pay for up to 50% of the project in rebates. Okay, first, let's talk about the average cost to install an EV charger in a house. I took a handful of all the most recent quotes I received and compared them all to get an average cost for these projects. I rounded the numbers up a little bit just to be safe. So in most cases, the prices will come in a little bit lower than the numbers I'm about to give you. The installation will be the most expensive portion of the project. This includes the parts, the labor, and also the electrical permit, which the electrician should take care of for you. The cost of install for these projects averaged out to around $2,000. Next is the cost of the EV charger. They're super cheap EV chargers and pretty expensive EV chargers, but I would recommend getting one of pretty good quality. If you budget $1,000 for the EV charger, that'll be more than enough. So with all this being said, the cost to install a level 2 EV charger in a house usually floats between $3,000 and $3,500 in most cases. Now, this is the case if you don't have to deal with the next three things that I'm going to mention. If you're unlucky and your house has these three features, then you can expect the price of the project to increase. The first one is probably the most straightforward, and it's the age of the house. In my experience, the older the house, the more expensive the install tends to be. An old house usually means old electrical wires, and when the electrician starts pulling them out, sometimes they're just simply too old and not in very good condition, so they need to be replaced. The second one, and probably the biggest factor, is having limited power available in the house. You need a decent amount of power. If you have a 200 amp panel, then you're probably golden. But if you only have 100 amps, then you might be required to get what's called an electrical service upgrade. If you have to get an electrical service upgrade, this will by far be the biggest factor that will make your project way more expensive. The third one, and this one's not that big of a deal, but the further away your electrical room is from where your chargers are going is going to increase the price of the project. Longer distance means longer electrical wires and conduit, and installing all that conduit takes a long time, and this is going to increase the labor hours that are spent on site by the electrician. So if the stars align and everything works out in your favor, with a newer house, a lot of power, and a close electrical room, it's possible that the install could come in under $1,000. But if you have an older house and you need an electrical service upgrade, then you're looking at probably closer to around $7,000. The only way to determine the true cost is to have an electrician stop by and provide a quote. They'll often do this for free. If you have questions or need help, I'd be happy to help point you in the right direction. I work with a handful of electricians who I trust, and they're very professional and always give me great pricing. I really hope this helped, and as always, feel free to give me a shout. And if you want to keep following the journey, please subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks so much for checking in, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.